After eating, it's normal for our blood sugar level to go up. That's completely healthy. But some people have abnormally high or abnormally long spikes. The glucose just takes too long to normalize again. The typical example are type 2 diabetics, and some people have glucose intolerance without having full-blown diabetes. So for those cases, here are four simple tips to blunt those excessive spikes explained by Dr. Mario Kratz.
The biggest ones, I would say, are to not eat highly glycemic carbs by itself. So let's imagine if you ate a white toast with just a little bit of butter and maybe jam or honey or, you know, something like that, which, you know, here in Germany, a lot of people like eating for breakfast. And so they may have two or three slices of that. And that's mostly carbs and very highly glycemic carbs. That's certainly the kind of meal that is most likely to give you these types of spikes. The suggestion there is ideally to move to a food with, you know, high carbohydrate food with a lower glycemic index, right, if possible. And or ideally both, to also eat the food with a source of protein and ideally a high fiber vegetable or fruit. Because the fiber and the protein both have several different effects on the blood sugar response. But one is that it slows down gastric emptying. The best studies that have actually tested this, they looked at the order in which these foods are eaten. If you have chicken and broccoli and rice, and you say you eat the rice first and then the chicken and then the broccoli, then you get a big blood sugar spike. Many people get a blood sugar spike. If you eat the broccoli first and then the chicken and then the rice, you get, you know, your blood sugar increases maybe 50% lower and you don't get a spike. Now, what they usually don't compare in these studies is the way most people eat, and that would be all of the foods together. And our best estimate would be that that's somewhere in the middle, but probably closer to eating a chicken and broccoli first, simply because you'll dramatically reduce the rate of gastric emptying when you ingest the rice with something that needs to be digested in the stomach, and that's protein. And then on top of that, the protein itself has an insulinemic effect. So it boosts your insulin response slightly. And that also is thought to have a beneficial, you know, attenuating effect on your blood glucose levels. So that's one big thing. You know, try to avoid eating highly glycemic carbs by itself, and instead ideally eat carbs with a lower glycemic index in a meal together with protein. Can be a small piece of protein. So it could be legumes. Legumes actually have been tested a lot here. Could be a piece of meat, piece of fish, shellfish, eggs, tofu, you know, anything that in Greek yogurt, anything that incorporates some protein. And then I think ideally having some fiber-rich vegetables is good, or fiber-rich berries or fruit. So as an example, if you wanted to replace your breakfast of your toast with jam, you could have, for example, some eggs with vegetables, or some Greek yogurt with some berries, for example. Or if you still want to eat your toast with jam, you know, maybe have a breakfast egg with it or before that, you know, so that you just slow them. You'll probably see a fairly substantial reduction there. And I'd say if I had to pick the second, I would say after highly glycemic meals, go for a walk. Because as the muscle is contracting, it is able to take up glucose from the blood in a manner that is entirely independent of insulin. So if insulin resistance or lack of insulin is an issue for you in contributing to this blood sugar spike, then going on a walk will basically help your body clear glucose from the blood in a way that doesn't depend on being insulin sensitive or having enough insulin in the blood, right? And I like these two suggestions simply because even independent of the effect on the blood sugar rise, they're good things. If we think about why people develop blood sugar spikes, we mentioned it could be some combination of being slightly insulin resistant or having, you know, a reduced ability to produce insulin. Or it could be because of the poor meal, right? I mean, say toast with jam is just not a very nutritious meal in the first place, right? There's very few micronutrients. There's very, very little fiber in there. it's calorically dense. We probably like it so much because it's sweet, and we overeat it. So replacing this or with another meal that's more that has some protein and fiber, or even adding or just adding some protein and fiber-rich foods, I think will increase the value of the meal per se, and that I think in the long term could certainly have other benefits to address, say, issues with weight or insulin resistance that may underlie the spike, right? So, in other words, I'd like to encourage basically making changes that don't just address the spike. There's some others, like people have heard probably taking vinegar or these types of things. Not that I'm against vinegar or something, but the issue I think is that ideally we make changes that improve the underlying factors as well, or at least give us a chance to improve the underlying factors. And increasing our protein intake and increasing our intake of fiber-rich vegetables or fruit are definitely two good things in my book. And going for a walk certainly as well, and having a little bit more physical activity. So those would probably be my top two candidates for things I would try if I was experiencing blood sugar spikes regularly.